So let us start MySQL, right? Already we have started in the offline class. Now here again, I have to create the table and all the formalities I have to redo. So be patient and listen the lecture very carefully. The first command that we always create is create database. I am giving the name to database term 2. Okay, this database already exists. So I directly connect with this database. Already term 2 database exists in the MySQL. So I am directly connecting with the term 2 database. If you are creating the database for the first time, the command will be create database and the name of the database. Then after you create the database, you are to connect with the database, and the command to connect is connect and the name of the database. Clear? Now, once you get connected with the database, you can create multiple tables in that particular database. As I told you earlier, that database is collection of tables. You can create as many tables as you want in the database, right? In order to create the table, the command is create table. I am giving the name board 2. The name of my table is board 2. Press the enter key, opening right bracket. Here you are to specify the field name, the data type, and the constraint if you want. I am giving the first field is roll number of type integer, and I am putting a constraint onto it, that is primary key. Now today I'll be telling you the role of first constraint, that is the primary key constraint. Primary key constraint is a constraint that helps us to uniquely identify the record or the tuples in the table. There are two most important conditions for the primary key. Whichever field you are placing as primary key, or you want to make that particular field as primary key, two conditions you are to keep into mind. First is you cannot insert null value in that field. Second, you cannot insert duplicate values for that particular field. Jaise maan lo maine roll number ko primary key banaya. Ab roll number wale column ke andar main na to null value de sakta hu, na hi main do bachcho ka roll number same rakh sakta hu. These two are the most important conditions which are to be checked while putting the key under the primary key constraint. Right? Because primary key cannot be null, it cannot have duplicate values. How to put the field under the primary key constraint, the name of the field, data type, and write primary key. Okay? Then comma, then enter. I am giving the name. This is of string type. Okay. Then next I am giving marks of type float. Okay. Then I am giving grade of single character. Clear. Then I am giving city, again of string size. Okay. This is my last field. So I am closing the bracket over here and I am putting the semicolon, and my table got created. Remember one important point. There can be only one primary key in one table. अब मेरा जो ये बोर्ड टू का टेबल है, बेशक मैंने इसके अंदर मल्टीपल फील्ड्स ली हुई है, बट आई कैन टेक ओनली वन फील्ड एज प्राइमरी की. ओनली वन फील्ड विल बी टेकन एज प्राइमरी की. यू कैन नॉट हैव मल्टीपल प्राइमरी कीज. ओके, नाउ आई इंसर्ट द फर्स्ट रिकॉर्ड, इंसर्ट इन टू बोर्ड टू वैल्यूज, रोल नंबर 1, नेम अंकित, देन मार्क्स 80, ग्रेड ए, देन सिटी आई एम टेकिंग दिल्ली. फर्स्ट रो गॉट क्रिएटेड. ओके, नाउ यूजिंग द एरो कीज, ऑलरेडी आई हैव टोल्ड यू इन द ऑफलाइन क्लासेस, you can make changes here. Okay, capital B, then you can give here, this is the second row you have created. Now third row. Now see what I'm going to do in third row. In the third row, I am not changing the roll number. I am giving the same roll number as already I have given to the previous candidate. I am making the duplicate values. Why I am doing this? To show you the proper use of primary key. That how primary key will generate error when you are giving the same value to more than one record. Check it out. Duplicate entry 2 for the key primary. Have you noticed, everyone? Yes. Samriddhi, Maulik, Mohit. Have all of you noticed what I have done? Tanisha, Anushka. All right. Now, one thing is proved that you cannot enter the duplicate values when you are specifying the values for the primary key field. Okay, so I'm going to make solution to it. I have to change the roll number. So I'm changing the name and I'm giving the value over here. Yeah. Now it is okay because I have changed the roll number. Okay. Now another thing, insert into board 2. Now, in the insert into command, after giving the table name, I repeat, in the insert into command, after giving the table name, you will specify the fields for which you want to give the values. Aap jis field mein value dena chahte ho, wo field ke naam type kar do. Aap jis field ko value nahi dena chahte, us field ko skip kar do. Ab maine kya kiya? रोल नंबर को स्किप कर रहा हूं. इररिस्पेक्टिव रोल नंबर इज द प्राइमरी की. आई एम गिविंग नेम कॉमा मार्क्स. आई एम गिविंग द वैल्यू फॉर ग्रेड. आई एम लिविंग सिटी ऑल्सो. आई एम लिविंग सिटी ऑल्सो. वैल्यूज नेम Chetan, marks 90, and grade I am giving A. Check it out. Another error caused due to violation of primary key constraint. another error that occur because I violate the rules of primary key. पहला रूल तो वायोलेट हुआ था कि प्राइमरी की में डुप्लीकेट वैल्यू आ गई थी. सेकेंड रूल विच आई हैव ब्रेक्ड इज आई ट्राइड टू गिव द नल वैल्यू इन द प्राइमरी की फील्ड. प्राइमरी की फील्ड कैन नॉट हैव नल वैल्यू. हां, विच एवर अदर फील्ड विच आर नॉट प्राइमरी, अदर फील्ड विच आर नॉट प्राइमरी, देयर यू कैन गिव द नल वैल्यू. ओके, but especially when you have primary key, there you cannot give the null value. So you have to give the value for the primary key field. So I am making up the loss. Okay. 4. I'm giving the value here. 4 comma. Okay. But here, see carefully what I have done. When I am giving this value, I have omitted the city field. I have omitted the city field. Now, city field can have null value. Why city field can have the null value? Because I haven't applied any constraint on the city field. Check the table carefully. Check the physical layout of the table carefully. मैंने city field के आगे कोई constraint नहीं लगाया हुआ. तो यहां पे null value applicable. You can see the entire table by giving this command select star from table name. Check it out. Check the last एंट्री केयरफुली. लास्ट रिकॉर्ड को देखिए ध्यान से. द सिटी इज हैविंग नल वैल्यू फॉर द लास्ट रिकॉर्ड. द सिटी इज हैविंग द नल वैल्यू फॉर द लास्ट रिकॉर्ड. एम आई क्लियर टू ऑल? एनी डाउट, एनी क्वेरीज अप टिल हियर? समृद्धि, मौलिक, मोहित, कॉन्सेप्ट इज अंडरस्टूड? All right. Now I go with the other commands. Suppose you want to display the table in a sorted way. You want to display your data in the table in proper sorting, in ascending or descending order. The command is order by. Select star from table name, order by command is used to display the record in ascending or descending order. The default ordering is ascending. अगर आप कुछ भी specify नहीं कर रहे तो असेंडिंग ऑर्डर में सॉर्टिंग होगी. बट ऑर्डर बाय कमांड परफॉर्म्स द सॉर्टिंग ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ एनी फील्ड. डिपेंडिंग ऑन एनी फील्ड यू कैन डू द सॉर्टिंग. लाइक यू हैव 5 फील्ड राइट नाउ. ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ एनी फील्ड यू कैन परफॉर्म द सॉर्टिंग. लाइक आई वॉन्ट टू अरेंज द डाटा इन असेंडिंग ऑर्डर ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ marks. So you write here order by marks. अब मैंने कुछ नहीं लिखा, ना ascending ना descending. So but obvious the default order is ascending. Check it out. Check the column of the marks. According to the column of the marks, the sorting has been done in ascending order. Still, if you want to show ascending, you can write the keyword ASC. Order by ke baad field ka naam, field ke naam ke baad keyword de do ASC. ASC keyword signifies ascending. check it out. Am I clear to all? Next, if you want to show in descending order, the keyword is DESC. The keyword to show descending order is DESC. Right? Check it out. The highest marks are displayed first, the lowest at the end. Yes, 12th class, am I clear to all? Up till here, the order by command. Now, the next command is distinct command. What is the role of distinct? Distinct means to eliminate the duplicate values. Okay? Agar aapki field mein duplicate values hai, और आपने उस फील्ड के ऊपर डिस्टिंक्ट कीवर्ड लगा दिया, ऑल द डुप्लीकेट वैल्यूज विल बी एलिमिनेटेड एंड इट विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज वन वैल्यू. जैसे सपोज अभी राइट नाउ हियर आई कैन प्लेस ऑन ग्रेड बिकॉज देर आर टू ग्रेड्स विद द नेम ए. टू ग्रेड्स आर देयर हैविंग ए ग्रेड, सो डुप्लीकेट वैल्यूज आर देयर. आई कैन अप्लाई द डिस्टिंक्ट कीवर्ड clearly on grade column, select distinct grade from board 2. Check it out. Distinct grade from board 2. Check it out. The duplicate entry of A is treated as one. All the values in that particular field will get displayed. All the values of that particular field will get displayed, eliminating the duplicate values. ठीक है? For example, अगर मैं एक और record write करूं, insert into board 2 values roll number 5, name Daman, marks 70, grade B, or city de do Lucknow. Okay. Right, so this is my table. Now there are two grades having A, two grades with a value B. Select distinct grade from board 2. Check it out. A was repeated twice, it appear only once. B grade was twice, it appear only once. This is the role of distinct keyword. Okay. If I give all keyword, all grade from board 2, it will print all the values of the field, including the duplicate. Check it out. I hope the difference in all keyword and distinct keyword is totally clear to everyone. Any queries, any doubt up till here? Yes, please. Maulik, Mohit, Vaibhav, Anushka, Tanisha, Sukhmani, Shailza, any doubt to any one child? All right. Now I'm going to do one more thing on distinct. Pay attention carefully. And if you feel any doubt, you can raise your hand. I will unmute you. अभी इस कमांड को देखो, आई हैव टेकन ओनली द डिस्टिंक्ट कीवर्ड, आई हैव टेकन ओनली द डिस्टिंक्ट कीवर्ड, ओके। नाउ हेयर सिलेक्ट, आई एम यूजिंग द काउंट फंक्शन, काउंट फंक्शन इज यूज टू काउंट द एंट्री, काउंट फंक्शन इज यूज टू काउंट द एंट्री, ओके। काउंट ब्रैकेट डिस्टिंक्ट ग्रेड फ्रॉम बोर्ड टू 12th क्लास, पे अटेंशन टू दिस कमांड एंड टू द प्रीवियस कमांड वेयर माई एरो इज मूविंग। Alone, distinct. Now, distinct is inside the count function. These are totally two different commands. जब आप अकेला distinct लोगे बिना count function के, तो क्या होगा? उस column की सारी values print होगी duplicate हटाकर. When you will take count distinct inside the count function, It will count the total values for that column, excluding the duplicate values. Answer will be 3. Anybody can tell me why the answer is 3? Any child who can tell me the reason why answer is 3? It means the child has understood the logic. One who can tell me the logical reason why the value is 3. Anmol has raised hand. Yes, Anmol, unmute yourself.
So distinct means different values. There are 3 values, different A, B, C.
Yes.
So that's why they have taken.
Yeah, there are total 3 grades, A, B, and C. Duplicate ko hata ke to 3 grade hi reh gaye. A, B, C, 3 is the value. Very right. Good. Nice. So I hope the difference in single distinct and count distinct is thoroughly clear to everyone. Okay. All right. Now I'm going to type one command. You are to raise your hand to tell me the output. Select name from board to where marks between 60 and 70. I will not press the enter key. Raise your hand and tell me the output of this command. Between command, I have discussed with you people. Malik has raised hand. Yes, Malik. Unmute yourself.
Sir, 60 and 70 marks wale sare display ho jayenge.
All the students who are having the marks in 60 and 70, their name will get displayed. So what name will get print, Malik?
Sir, Anoop.
Anoop.
Brijesh.
And Daman. Anoop, Brijesh and Daman. These 3 name will get print. Okay. Fine. All right. So this is the answer. You can check it out. Anoop, Brijesh and Daman. Clear? All right. I am typing one more command. Tell me the answer of this. Select star from board to where city equal to Delhi. Yes. What will be the answer to this command? Tell me. हाँ जी बताइए, Yes, who will tell the answer to this command? Raise your hand, please. Select star from board 2, where city equal to Delhi. This is the table. Again, Malik. Why not other student participate? Samriddhi, Mohit, Vaibhav, Anushka. Okay, Anushka, unmute yourself and tell me the answer.
So, Ankit.
Only Ankit? Asterisk laga hua hai. Asterisk matlab complete detail. Asterisk means complete detail. So what will get print? It will print the entire record of Ankit. 1 Ankit 88 Delhi. Check it out. Clear? Now, let us go with next constraint. That is the unique key constraint. For that, I am going to create one more table. Create table 12th. I am taking here admission number, integer, unique. I am taking subject 1, float. Subject 2, float. I am taking here percentage float, unique. When I discuss the primary key, I told you there can be only one primary key. And primary key is used to identify the record in the table. No two records can have the same value. Same concept is of unique constraint. Unique or primary ka meaning same hai. But there are some strong differences between the two. The first technical difference between the primary constraint and the unique constraint is there can be only one primary key constraint, but there can be multiple unique key constraints. Primary key constraint sirf ek ho sakta hai. Sirf ek field primary key ho sakti hai. But there can be multiple fields having unique constraint. You can check the table. Admission number of unique, percentage also unique constraint. Two unique constraints I have taken in one table. So there can be multiple unique constraints. Second technical difference. When you are taking the field as primary key, you cannot enter the null value. But when you are entering the field as unique constraint, you can enter the null value. Primary key field does not allow null value. Unique constraint field allows null value. Okay? Am I clear to all? But one thing is common between primary and unique. In both the constraints, you cannot enter duplicate value. Insert into 12th values, admission number 111, marks 90, 80, percentage 85.2. Then insert into, I'm keeping the same admission number, 85, 75, 80.5. Check it out. Error has come. I told you in unique key constraint also, you cannot have duplicate value. So you have to change the value. check it. Okay. Now see what I'm going to do. I'm going to give the null value. Subject 1, comma subject 2. Values 90, comma 90. It is working. I have given null value in the unique key field. It is working. Check it. But agar ye primary key field hoti, to null value nahi aa sakti thi. Wo null value par bhi error de deta. But ab ye unique constraint hai, isme null value aa sakti hai aur aapke samne result hai. Any queries, any doubt, any questions? Please raise your thumb if the lecture is totally clear to all of you. Yes? All right. Now, the next field is update. Update field we use, update command we use when we want to make changes in the record. If you want to make any sort of modifications in your existing records, that time we make use of update command. Update board 2. Pehle main table display kar dun board 2 ka. This is the table for board 2. Update board 2, set keyword marks equal to marks plus 5. You want that 5 marks are added in marks of all the students. Har bache ke 5 numbro se marks badh jaye. You want increase in the marks of the students by 5. Ab increase ki baat hui hai, to but obvious you want to make changes in the existing record. So you need to take the update command. So what is the syntax and the format for update command? Update table name, set keyword, that field which you want to change. You want to add 5 marks, marks plus 5. चेंज करने के बाद उसी फील्ड में मार्क्स दोबारा इंसर्ट कर दीजिए. नाउ दिस अपडेट आई एम टेकिंग विदाउट एनी कंडीशन, सो इट विल अफेक्ट ऑल द रिकॉर्ड्स. चेक इट. कंपेयर द मार्क्स इन द न्यू टेबल एंड द मार्क्स इन द प्रीवियस टेबल, यू विल फाइंड द डिफरेंस. Check it carefully, class. Is it clear to all? Yes. Am I clear to all, class? Okay.